Now it's time to train our model with AutoML. As Francesca described, basically, AutoML will take our data and run it through a number of machine learning algorithms. Then it'll identify which is the best one or most accurate. We can then use that to deploy in our web service so that we're always calling the most accurate model. First, I know that I need to import the class AutoML Config because I need to create this configuration so that I can run it. Next, I know that I need to specify my time series settings. Some of these settings are obvious. Time column name, we already defined above. Max horizon, we set to 14, so that way we can predict 14 days into the future. This will allow us to do a rolling prediction throughout all of our days. We want to specify United States as our country or region, so then that way we're bringing in the holidays from the US for those particular dates. I'll keep the target lags to auto, and I'll drop the casual and registered columns because those are essentially just a part of the count column, so we don't really need them. Next, I'm going to create my AutoML config. I knew my task was forecasting, but I'm really glad that I asked Francesca about the primary metric and blacklist models. The rest of the parameters for the AutoML config are fairly straightforward. For example, we want to use our training data, we want to use our target column, and we want to use our compute target. For the rest, I referenced some documentation on creating basic AutoML config objects. Let's go ahead and run this and make sure we don't have any errors. It's as if I set myself up for that. I added an extra T in settings. Let's run this again. Great, that looks like it worked. The last step is to actually run this experiment. So let's create a remote run on this experiment using our AutoML config that we just created. And let's print that out so that we can get the status. We'll run this cell. And we'll see that this run was just created on the experiment AutoML bike share forecast. It's got this ID. It's an AutoML type. It's not been started yet. We have a link to Azure Machine Learning Studio for details. And a link to further documentation. Let's go ahead and kick this run off. Now for you, this is only gonna take a split second. For me, it could take anywhere from 5 minutes to up to an hour. So you're gonna have to be patient on this one. I'll run that cell and wait patiently until it completes. And it's completed. Now we can see all of the details of the run, including a run ID, which specifies this specific run, and all of the parameters that we put into it. Now the next step is going to be identifying the best run and viewing the featureization summary of this run. I think I'm going to need some help from Francesca though. And before we can get her help, we really need to get our code into a cloud environment so that she can jump in and help us out.